scene from A Lovely Afternoon, and it's a play about a young man that invites his girlfriend over to his house, and she comes not knowing that there's nobody else home, and they wind up in his bedroom, and you can figure out the rest. Oh, it's so hard to believe all the good times we've had, all the bad times. We've laughed together, cried together. We did it on our first algebra test together. Now it's all over. I even remember the first movie we saw together. It was...
Famous Fire.
We've lived, we've loved, we've had our fill, our share of losing. Tears, we love arrived, and though it seems all so confusing. Come on, one more time. For all time's sake?
No! You didn't think it would work, did you?
No, I guess not.
We've lived and tried. What a pile of melodrama.
Easy for you to say. You've had your Phil, your Paul, and your Marty.
No, wait a minute. Wouldn't have had it for you, Armin, if you hadn't tried to do what you tried to do.
Would you stop with that try to do business? I mean, what did you think? I was going to try to... I mean, what's a guy supposed to do with a pretty girl in an empty house?
You can thank society for that.
For what? A pretty girl in an empty house?
For the way you've been brought up.
I thought I could thank my parents for the way I've been brought up. Do you know something I don't?
Society is so sex-oriented. You've been brought up to believe that a boy and a girl in an empty house do what you were trying to do.
Hey, nobody told me what boys and girls do in empty houses. I found it out for myself.
There are literally hundreds of things we can do in here besides...
Okay, Miss Guinness Book of World Records. Give me a couple hundred things we can do in here besides, you know.
Well, there's, you know...
Aha!
What?
You know was the first thing that came to your mind, too.
No! I didn't mean you know as you know. I meant it as, you know what I...
Okay, give me one thing we can do in here besides, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, there are hundreds of things, thousands of things.
We can play games.
Yeah.
I'll think of a game. Yeah. We can play cards.
Yeah, let's play Old Maid.
What do you want to
play? Well... There's,
We'll play gym. Yeah, we'll play cards and have a real nice time. Get your mind off this whole unpleasant conversation. Well, you'd be amazed at how thoroughly engrossed once you get in a card game. Pretty soon, everything else will be oblivious to you. You don't have anything else on your mind except for cards and space?
You don't shut up, I'm not going to be able to concentrate on this game.
Go first. You know, it's funny. I can already see you getting involved in the pursuit of winning. Little wheels in your head are going clickety-click. I'll bet by the time we're finished with this game, you won't even remember what we were arguing about.
Gin, and I still remember.
Oh, you got gin!
Holy master of the game! Now what?
You got gin, Alan!
Isn't that the idea of the game?
Because you caught it in the first card. That's phenomenal! Aren't you excited?
Oh, I'm thrilled.
Do you realize what you have?
Yeah, I've had a headache for about the past 20 minutes.
Do you know what the odds are on getting gin on the first card?
No. Enlighten me, please.
It's something like 600,000 to 1, and you got it!
It was easy for me.
You don't understand the significance of this. I mean, people play gin all their lives, and half of them never get gin on the first card. I mean, what you've done is nearly impossible. You don't understand. You don't understand.
He sounds like Shakespeare.
Look, Mike. Alan. I'll bet there are hundreds of professional gin players who have never gotten to the first card.
I bet they all get sex.
Hey, some of us get gin, others get sex. It all works out.